So let's look at how oxygen is delivered from the red blood cells. There's what's called the oxyhaemoglobin dissociation curve. I only want to kind of go into it briefly. Has anybody heard of it before? You have. Okay. Just Kit. Nobody else, no? You've got your SpO2 here, and you've got your amount of oxygen dissolved directly in the blood here. This here measures how fully loaded is your hemoglobin with oxygen. This here measures the amount of oxygen in the blood, dissolved in blood. It's an S-shaped curve. If you breathe hard, yeah? The curve shifts to the left, so hard breathing, you lose CO2, the curve shifts to the left, so the oxygen dissociation curve shifts to the left, and basically hemoglobin holds on to oxygen. So I'll just say that again. If you breathe hard, you get rid of carbon dioxide. If you get rid of carbon dioxide, blood pH increases. This causes the curve to shift to the left. The harder you breathe, the more your red blood cells hold on to oxygen. If you want your blood to release oxygen, you need to have carbon dioxide. But if you're breathing too heavy, you're getting rid of too much CO2, and the bond between hemoglobin and oxygen increases. So here's the ironic thing. The harder you breathe, the more your blood vessels constrict, the more your airways constrict, and the tighter the bond between oxygen and hemoglobin. But also, the more stressed you are. That's it in a nutshell. So how do you measure how hard you breathe?
So is the point that you want the oxygen to be released from the hemoglobin?
Yes. But this is called the Bohr effect. This was discovered in 1904 by a physiologist called Christian Bohr. And what he said was, he said that the carbon dioxide pressure in the blood is very important. Now, many people talk about breathe in oxygen and get rid of carbon dioxide. Bring in oxygen because it's good, and get rid of carbon dioxide because it's that waste gas. So they're saying, get rid of as much CO2 as possible. But they're not realizing that actual transfer of oxygen from the blood takes place in the presence of carbon dioxide. That's very important. Having oxygen in your blood is not enough. If I was to measure your blood oxygen saturation, it'll be normal, be perfect. But you could be still tired and stressed and not getting enough oxygen delivery to the cells. It's not enough to have enough oxygen. Having your blood fully saturated with oxygen is not enough. You need to get the oxygen out of the blood to the cells. How do you get the oxygen out of the blood to the cells? Increased body temperature, carbon dioxide, increased dysphosphoglycerate, but we're looking at carbon dioxide in the presence of breathing.